Hi, it's Bob Kraft of tennisministry.org, and we're into the middle of April 2011, and I'd like to talk about Caroline Wozniacki today. She's a number one world-ranked player, and I first met her when she was probably about 15 years old. It's an interesting story. I was at the French Open in the Players' Lounge on the finals day of the men's singles, and I didn't have a ticket to get into the stadium. So I was a little bit, you could just say, not happy about that, because there were only five or six people out of this entire lounge that were sitting there without tickets, and I was one of them. And so guess who the other three players were? They were junior players. One was Caroline Wozniacki. She had just won the doubles title with Ursula Wawrinka, and Ursula's sister, Angeleska, had also won the singles title, junior title. So they were sitting at a table next to me, and in the players' restaurant, there were just the four of us. And this is kind of showing you how God works, because here I was, I wanted to go in and watch the finals, which, as I remember, was Roger Federer playing, and I didn't have a ticket to get in. So I was watching it on the TV, and I went over and sat down with them and started talking to them, and I noticed that they had crosses on. I didn't know who they were, and they said they were from Poland. So of course I knew that the Polish players had probably a Catholic background. It turned out that Caroline was from Denmark, but her parents were from Poland, and these three girls were friends. So we just started talking, and they were very happy to meet a pastor. And as I started to talk about God and faith, they really enjoyed listening and talking about it. So from that moment on, I was actually around those three players quite a lot. And as they went into the end of their teens, they started to move up the rankings, all three of them. Rawanska, Angeleska, actually was the best singles player. And she came up into the top 10 in the first player to do that among those three players. And her sister then started to play doubles more on the tour. But it was an interesting story, because Caroline was someone that, you know, I wouldn't have predicted to be the number one player in the world. She was thin, a little bit not very muscular, a little bit lanky, and she was very quiet. So most of the players who are number one are kind of, you know, talkative and bold you could say self-confidence. So Caroline, ever since that time, I've gone up and talked to her, and her mother and father knew me from that time. They weren't actually in the Players' Lounge that day. I'm not sure where they were. I don't think they were even at the French Open that year. I didn't see them. And the father became the coach and traveled up with Caroline, and usually you see the mother too traveling with Caroline. So it was an interesting relationship. During this period of time, she started to move up into the top 10 in the last few years, and I would see Caroline at different tournaments throughout the stop, for example, Tokyo or Beijing. And the last couple years, I always knew, having worked with number one world-ranked players, I kind of know the progression. They start off and people don't really know who they are, and then all of a sudden, when they get to be number one, very suddenly, the press descends on them, the agents come, all the equipment sponsors are trying to make contact with them, and they can very easily get confused, and that's kind of what's happened to Caroline. All of a sudden, she went from being not super popular, you could say, with everybody on the equipment side and the media side, and all of a sudden, everybody wants to talk to her. So last year, in the year 2009, I started to notice that she started to withdraw a little bit because of the pressures of being number one. And I've been telling her for about the last few years that God first, your family second, and your career third, or your profession. And I just keep repeating that over and over to her. And I've actually seen that in some press interviews where she's mentioned things similar to that. So I know it's had an impact on her. And you often see her with her cross on. Now, in the last few months, There have been times where they've done media and she didn't have her cross on. That's kind of surprising me because all those years she would wear her cross. And I think what happens is there's a little bit of pressure from equipment manufacturers or from agents not to wear your cross during photo shoots. And maybe that's part of it. I'm not really sure. But, you know, I do encourage her spiritually quite a lot. Now, it's interesting because her father, who's been her coach, as they would travel, the father and the mother, there were times where they weren't able to travel with Caroline a few years ago. So then they would have the Wozniacki family, mother and father, who was also, her father was coaching the Wozniackis, travel together. So they would all kind of travel. They were working together, these two families from Poland. And then there would be other times that Wozniackis wouldn't be able to travel with their parents, and they would travel with Caroline's mother and father. And it's interesting because there's that period of time where the father, she would lose a match, and he would, you would often see him sitting, you always see him actually sitting next to the court, and he runs down on the court and he gives her advice, and then he runs off the court. This is often on TV, so he's sitting within the view of the camera. But it's very interesting because she would lose a match, and she would come off the court, and he would really be tough on her. We could say even belittle her. It was in the form of advice, but it was very public, and it would be in the players' restaurants. And I always felt, actually, I don't know, I can't even describe the words for that. I've seen parents who've been tough with their children. For example, Yuri Sharapova was tough with Maria publicly at different times. But that's gone on with Caroline. And, you know, there's a great love relationship there, but on the other hand, it's a very public and it's a very humiliating thing too. She sits there and listens, and it's in the form of advice, but it's very very tough and very belittling, and it's always in public. And so that goes on. But you know, you can't really say that the results are bad because she is number one in the world, and I'm thankful for that. I pray that she keeps having a public witness with her cross, but at the other hand, you know, her voice, she can use her voice to impact millions of people around the world about her faith in Christ and her relationship with the church. I don't think her mother and father, outside of growing up in the Catholic Church and coming from a background like that, have a real strong relationship with the church. Her father was a professional soccer player, and then they moved to Denmark, and he reestablished his family there when Caroline was very little. So she's actually Danish, but still in her heart, she has a Polish heart, you could say. So there's something about Caroline that's a little bit different because her faith is deep in her heart. And when I've spoken to her, which is quite frequently, you can sense that it's deep in her heart. It means a lot to her. And the best I can do is just pray for her, continue to encourage her, because usually when a player gets to be a top player, you can't really spend a lot of time with them. They have a lot of people trying to be around them. And the best thing I've done is to keep it short and sweet, you could say. Just a very short thing that you pray beforehand is the right thing to say. So I continue to say God first, your family second, and your career third. And then I have spoken to her about the pressures that come with being number one in the world. So that's Caroline. We wish her the best. She's a great girl. She's been a good role model for tennis. You know, I did notice at a tournament in Thailand, I wasn't there, but it was through the media that she was doing a Buddhist kind of a thing, because the tournament organizers were encouraging her to do a Buddhist greeting and so forth. And that's not a very healthy thing for a Christian to do, I can say. But on the other hand, I do know her, and I know that she is a good person who has been good for the sport. And I just encourage everyone here to pray for her and to that she can be used greatly by God to impact people. Thank you.